And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube, for some Twisted Deep. So this deck's very similar to the Discard Deep deck that we played about a week ago, with just a few changes here. This was a viewer-submitted deck, that's what the donation deck means. It changed a few things around to get more bodies in play. Like, we have Petty Officer, Coral Creatures, we can go deep a little faster with Jettison. That's what we're going to be trying to do. So we're going to try to be going deep for our Nautilus and our sea monsters, but then also have some good card advantage to help level up Twisted Fate and have Twisted Fate in here. We got some Spray Fins. That Spray Fin's always drawing either Lure the Depths or Jettison, so it definitely really helps with the sea monster aspect of our decks. The thing that we're going to struggle with a little bit here is removal. We got Agacha and Twisted Fate and Devourer Depths. That's what we have for removal. So that could be some struggle against like some champions that we need to get off the battlefield before they level up. But besides that, our deck's looking pretty good. So let's see how this does. I was really impressed with the Discard Deep deck that we played last week. This version changes about 12 cards that we have changed in here. Maybe 13 cards, something like that. About 12 cards, yeah, that we have changed in this version. So we'll see how these different cards do with the same overarching theme, same shell. Alright, so we're playing Gangplank Sejuani. We want to keep them from dealing Nexus damage each time that we can to keep those things from leveling up. Let's see what they do. Okay. No one drop.
This land is ours.
Okay, I'm gonna need to block that. I basically wanted to see if, you know, could we pull off the Lure of the Depths, but now we're gonna need to block that. So let's see, what am I gonna discard? I think it's Nautilus. We'll probably be able to find a new Nautilus.
Leave nothing standing.
As we dig through the deck. I like having Lure the Depths the next turn, and then we can have Abyssal Eye on 4, Devourer on 5. And so on.
Give me the stuff! Stuff make happy!
the deck that you just... What kind of deck, Saymon? The mill deck that you just donated for? Or this deck that you're playing here? Or that we're playing right now?
Fight or die!
I guess it's not great to play Abyssal Eye right now because I can't block either of those with Abyssal Eye. So maybe we just play... Just play these things. Beast Below. I don't really want to discard any sea monsters with them all costing less. Like, they're all going to be pretty decent. We'll see if we get to hit them and draw a new card.
I rarely forget and never forget.
Captain on deck.
And then, oh man, Shipwreck Hoarder? I don't want to discard that either. I mean, I can discard this other Abyssal Eye. We'll do that. But But definitely want to get another blocker out here. So 21, we're so close.
Like a fish in water.
Man, this is tough. So I could... Yeah, I mean, we gotta do this.
I'm always up for a round or two.
If I go... The dredgers... Ouch. That was a great Mega Rain. Yeah, we could go dredgers with the jettison and go deep.
You'll fight or you'll swim.
Round them up.
Hmm. So we'll have 6-6 Abyssal Eye that will kill the Gangplank. And now I devour, get rid of the Spray Fin so that the Abyssal Eye gets to hit them. Mine.
Deal me in.
Red card.
I'm a people person.
Got a couple of clutch Twisted Fate draws.
I'm not greedy. My friends, though.
Lilies?
Boo. Yeah, I should have played the 4-4 first before the Twisted Fate to get more red card value, and that's I tried to pull it down, but at that I put the Twisted Fate up a little too fast, and then I wasn't able to do that. But yes, I should have done that. All right, GG's. It's kind of a weird game to navigate at first, but you know, the lure the depth, you know, going deep super fast and then lure the depths, giving us a whole bunch of sea monsters, you know, got us there. And there we go. First game, GG. I think that this new version of Deep is better than the other version of Deep, the old version. A couple of caveats. One, the last time, we just played the old version of Deep yesterday, and that list that we played yesterday was definitely the best version of the Maokai Nautilus Deep I've ever played. And so, if you like the old version of Deep, I recommend checking out the YouTube video from yesterday with that version. Two, I haven't, you know, we only played one game with this version so far, but I would recommend, I think I'd recommend the Discard Deep more than this version, the Discard Deep that I played last week. Again, that's just with only one game under our belt, and that game was pretty impressive that we played, so we'll see afterwards, but I really liked that version that we played last week. No, there's no way in client to check how many games you played and your win rates and stuff like that, but you can have a third-party application that can check that. Mobilytics does a good job of tracking that if you have a Mobiletics account. And Mobiletics is where I have all of my decks. Yeah, it's there with the stats and stuff. There you go, the combo linked. Salvage gone.
There's another one.
Perfect. I was gonna say that basically whatever coral creatures made is what we were gonna be discarding to the urchin. And that worked out. Not sure if I'm supposed to just attack and let their 1-1 kill my 2-1 and now their 4-4 just kill my 1-2. Just get 3 damage in and free up 2 slots and... thinking maybe not with Jarl Hunters. Maybe so. They definitely have things they can play.
All the world on one arrow.
Hot on the trail.
Alright, get some blocks. So I'm gonna be leading with Jarl Hunters. Kind of incentivizing them to try Reckoning where I would have Gotcha to kill the 5-1 in response. Because we'll have 8 total mana, so we'll be able to do that. Shipwreck Hoarder. That card's cool. Yeah, I would be very happy if they cast Reckoning right now. If they play Yeti first, then I challenge the 5-1. Cattle the Arm.
Set the hooks!
If I go for Kato, they can use Elixir of Iron or Brittle Steel. If I go for Ash, they can only use Brittle Steel. So our Gotcha just killed Ash and traded with Brittle Steel as well. You know, got 2-for-1.
Tribes.
round. Alright, 22 cards left. So Jettison's not getting there yet. They like to play slow. So yeah, now Reckoning, you know, that thing only costs one mana. They can still have Reckoning. Yeah, that Reckoning would be devastating now. I don't think I just play Devour. I think we'll wait, because if they do have Reckoning, I'm going to need to play other things.
Sharpen the blade, secure the kill.
Danger paid.
For how they waited on the gacha, that does kind of make it seem like they have Elixir of Iron, and so I kind of want to wait on the Devourer for us to go deep first before playing it. But I guess... Let's see, so I'm... still 7 cards away from deep. They could not play slower.
I give you muscle,
fish out of water. Reel him in.
No kills, no entry.
Just gonna play Shipwreck Porter next turn. What do I do with this urchin? Do I just discard the hoarder to the urchin? Discard Petty Officer? Came back. Both cards that we thought about discarding, it came right back. His Elixir of Iron doesn't save this thing now. So that's good.
Victory requires a sharp blade.
Might lure the depths.
Go time!
For glory, you're mine.
They only have 2 cards in hand. We're not doing that bad. We're at 19, so this thing's gonna be a 7-7, so we'll block Kato with the 7-7. We'll block the 5-1 with the 1-1. If we ever get priority. We're honestly not doing bad. Just don't look at our life total. Oh, sorry, block. Alright, let's get those two treasures in the deck.
You'll fight or you'll swim.
Cool, good one drop. So when would the Shipwreck Order last turn instead of Devour, even though you know they'd have no spells to interact with Devour, because we were about to go to 9 mana and I could play Devour with the 3 drop here, and so obviously we're gonna be trying to get rid of Cat of the Arm. Oh no. Oh no. Well, I didn't feel bad until that. I guess that means that we have to... So I have to get rid of the Glory Seeker. Which means I might as well play Jawl Hunters to get rid of Glory Seeker instead of Devourer. Well, no, I have to go Devour, because I have to have Shipwreck Order, and I have to have an 8-8 and a... Yeah, I have to have an 8-8, or a 10-8 and a 7-7 to block these things. So no, I can't go Jawl Hunters, because I need these two big things on defense against the two Catos. There's no, like, fast spells for me to use to find for removal, right?
It is me! I'm always up for a round or two. All that glitters.
Alright, that stops one for a minute. Arguably, Shipwreck Order would have been better to play. Actually, it may have been better to play. Okay, so they're gonna have 16 overwhelm. We'll have 15 on defense, so we're gonna be taking 1 damage. So down to 2. But those are all gone. See if we get a treasure with our 5 mana. Ooh, what do we get? Treasure Trove. Absolutely, Ed. Yep, always take donation decks. Oh, it looks like Choo Choo had a donation deck a little bit ago that I missed. Got a lot of donation decks in today. Dang.
They'll be blood in the water.
And they call me a shark.
Well, I'm casting all of them. Yeah, unfortunately Rex doesn't do a whole... I mean, it's a 7-4. So Juju had Twisted Karma. Sorry, opponent. I'm not wasting time. There we go. Sounds like, uh-oh. Oh, no more sea monsters to draw. No, because I just drew that one. No. Even if like their plan is like Sejuani to make something, you know, like make like a 3-2 frostbite and vulnerable, then we just replace, or you know, Twisted Fate, they make that frostbite vulnerable, we just replace that because we have the 6 units, so like it's all good. We don't have to worry about Sejuani. I guess I maybe should have gone Jawl Hunters here on the 3-2 and then would have had lethal if they don't play anything else because they couldn't have blocked one of those big things. So yeah, like I feel...
Blood and guts, golden glory.
Yeah, or we just go Devour. I feel pretty good because even Sejuani doesn't bother us. So they need Captain Farron. They need Captain Farron get Decimate.
Carved from the Savage Cold.
Okay. That is an oath. 9. Fury of the North doesn't save him.
Stand and fight.
Oh no. Culling Strike, what am I doing? What am I doing? Culling Strike saves them. I couldn't think of anything that would save them. Culling Strike did. Oh no. Man, that definitely should have been a win. Okay, what I was scared of, honestly what I was scared of there, I forgot about Culling Strike. So I was scared, I could only play one unit, right? I couldn't play two. My two units both, they cost 11 mana total, so I couldn't play both. So what I was scared of was that that was like a trick of then I replace that thing and then they'd make like the 2-2 vulnerable. Somehow like they would have like Caught in the Cold to make that vulnerable, but I guess they would have to have a pump spell to stay alive if I do the 7-7 anyway. So that was just, yeah, that was just bad by me. I really needed to just play the 7-7 and save that. Yeah, that was a throw. That was just, should have been an easy win, because then they couldn't have a pump spell and that. Really, the only thing they could like Battle. They couldn't even play Battle Fury because they couldn't have Sejuani and Battle Fury. Wow, that was the perfect two cards to get me, and the great play by going after the 09, and I just didn't think of Culling Strike for some reason when I was thinking of cards. That was bad. Yes, I know. I should have used Devour on Sejuani. Well, it should be 2-0. But I'm not. I made a mistake. The perfect card to punish. Alright, let's see. I mean, if I would have just played the 4-1, last turn, would have won that also. So lots of ways I should have won that. Just gonna keep all these. Swain Twisted Fate is usually more of a control deck, and so I'm gonna keep all these card draw cards. That's what I'm thinking. We can play the Dredgers later. Packed them good.
Got a surprise for him.
All right, Kordak. Thanks to the donation deck there. Man, tons of donation decks today. Let's see, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Gotten 7 donation decks today. So it's Twisted Fate, Gangplank. Good one to hit.
I've worked up something special. This'll send them running.
Twisted Fate's gonna die.
Send him off.
But traded with some stuff. Is gone.
The few for the many.
A little unfortunate.
Danger paid.
Set the hook.
Where the trash?
Ooh, got some fighting, yeah.
Good. No more Mega Rains. Good. Alright, hope this works. We have a few jettisons to play to help it work. So I want to wait till I want to play the shipwreck hoarder first before the other jettison so that we can help try to draw these treasures. This would be just enough. Yeah, because the Swain levels up and goes to 3 health, but my devourer is at 4 health. Kind of glad they didn't just do that 3 damage to me. I need to keep devouring. Keep devouring or go for treasures? Go for treasures. All right, cool, Ed. Will do.
Safety will cost you.
Man, I really hope they didn't just steal my treasure.
Heavy pockets, huh?
Yeah, this has got to be game. We just don't have removal. I don't have any removal to look for.
Boys.
There's one gotcha in our deck, it got tossed. I was hoping to find the treasure chest, and we'd be able to play the treasure chest, and maybe that'd give us some life gain cards. But no, they were just too fast. They were a lot faster than I thought they were gonna be. So obviously these salvages didn't look good.
For conquest, for empire.
A lot faster than I was expecting. They had the double deckhand, double make it rain. Hired gun, you know, like they had all that stuff. Pretty good. Yeah, they have, the Yordle Grifters are very good. Alright, so Ed had another donation deck. It's a slow aggro with Vlad and Braum. Okay. Cool. All right, playing against regular deep. Do I keep salvage? Definitely a matchup where we want to be the first person to go deep. Like, you want to go deep really fast. Does salvage help with that? It gets rid of 4 cards. Okay, I'm glad I mulliganed the one, especially with drawing another. Having one salvage is okay, but I really didn't want to have 2.
Stow the rations!
Hopefully 2 power. Yuck. Worst card to get. Just because of the mana, I'm gonna play this.
Go with the flow.
So we get that one mana back. So we're at 27. They're basically the same. It's a very fast pass. Ten away from deep. Salvage would be 4. This jettison's 4. Like, I want to play Abyssal Eye, but it's probably better just to be playing Salvage and Jettison and stuff like that.
There's another one!
Okay, so all of our jettisons are gone, so we know the spray fin is going to draw Allure the Depths at this point.
Vessel small, but she ain't lacking courage.
So next turn we'll be able to be deep. And we'll play Nautilus. It'll be deep. And then we'll be able to start dropping some other stuff. I guess I should have blocked with the Plunder Poro previously, I guess, shouldn't I? I thought I'd block with that Plunder Poro to free up room, and I wish I did.
Let's see if legends bleed.
Oh well, we'll just go over it.
Not today, little ones. Dive deeper.
Okay, so now the spray fin has nothing to draw. Tossed 2 Lure the Depths. We played 1. Played 2 Jettisons, tossed the other.
Pay the tithe.
Stare at the abyss. It'll stare back.
Seems like a reasonable block. It did have Ruination. Yep, they got me. So I shouldn't have played Abyssal Eye. Should have played like this Terror of the Tides. Yeah, because then I could have had Abyssal Eye with Twisted Fate. I guess I just go Terror of the Tides. 9. No, I guess that would have cost mana. I'm sure. I guess I should have just gone straight to combat. I guess that's the thing I should have done against Ruination. Keep them from tossing these couple cards. Well, at least that's not Vengeance on Nautilus. That's the good news. So I have 12 cards left. I should do.
Blue as the serpentine.
Could just play a whole bunch of stuff again, but you know, maybe they, you know, like with like Nautilus, but again, maybe they
like a fish in water.
No, the Shipwreck Order. That was the one card I really wanted. And Doll Hunters that makes it. I don't want these cards at all. And I really wish we would have just tossed these two and drawn the other two. The other two were the two I wanted. Yeah, Niceville sure can. Twisted Fate and Arena Bookie. I have done that before, Niceville. I did have a Twisted Fate Arena Bookie before, but I can switch it up and do different, something a little different with it. What'd they do? They played Thresh. Playing Thresh means not Ruination. So I could replay that deck. If you like it, or I could try building it a little different. There you go. So don't need to worry about Ruination. So we're just good to throw things down now. Sure. Don't really know why this Thresh isn't challenging anything. I guess I'm gonna just go for obliterating the Thorny Toad instead of the Thresh. Because of, like, Vile Feast. Yeah, okay, so that's...
You will feast soon enough.
I should be GG's. But we'll see. There we go. Yeah, this is crazy. I've never had this many donation decks in a day. It's like everybody was saving it up for Thursday. We may have to just do one of these donation decks over playing, instead of playing Light and Ice up next, maybe we should just do another donation deck just to get, you know, to do one of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You get 10 today? No, 9. You got 9 today. One at the end of the stream yesterday. Now I have 13 in the queue. I've never had that many in the queue. Alright, Swain at Twisted Fate. Again. Don't want to get ran over like last time. Jawl Hunters is weird because it's super easy to kill Jawl Hunters, but Jawl Hunters is also just a good card. Like counterfeit copies, like Lure of the Depths, and get a bunch more Lure of the Depths, or we could do it on Twisted Fate and get a bunch more Twisted Fates. Kind of want to go counterfeit copies on Lure of the Depths. I guess we do have a limited number of sea monsters to draw. It's probably best. Probably best on Twisted Fate to just get more Twisted Fates. Or get more Shipwreck Hoarders in here. Get some more treasures.
Why are you here?
Get some more treasures, let's go. Oh, that was a bad block by me. I'm sorry. I was just thinking of counterfeit copy stuff. That was dumb. That was a bad block. I obviously should have just blocked the two power things and then red card and killed everything. That was bad. I was distracted by this new treasure. Maybe we could... Let's take this gold card now. Maybe we could... draw a treasure. You can play Shipwreck Hoarder, draw a treasure, and then copies the treasure.
Like a fish in water.
Looks like trouble.
Loyalty through conquest.
Blood and guts, golden glory.
Oh man. Oh man. Well, I really would play Urchin for a blocker, but I don't have anything to discard. So I guess I'm not doing that, unless I discard the counterfeit copies. I mean, I guess I could discard Salvage. No, I'm just gonna play Urchin.
Better than eating.
Man, I want to start playing Shipwreck Hoarder. But I also want to go gold card and kill Swain. What do I do?
I'm always up for a round.
Guess we kill Swain. Kind of the problem here is if they just play new Swain and then go straight to attacks, I won't have blocker for new Swain.
Deal me in.
Alright, Sprayfin, you're pretty cool, but I'm just never gonna be able to play you. Ooh, I like that jettison. Make it easier to find treasures. Stop killing me, opponent. Let's just play a longer game. Come on, stop killing me. Why won't they stop killing me? Yes, treasure trove. Let's go. Counterfeit copies treasure trove. Okay, we're doing it. Man, I need to, wait, I guess I don't need to play this blocker, do I? We still have something to block Twisted Fate. This doesn't help block these, so never mind. We're still fine for now. Okay, now I need to play this as a blocker. All right, so I guess I discard, do I discard Salvage? Or do I just discard Shipwreck Hoarder because we already got a bunch of other treasures in the deck? Which one of these two do I discard? Man, I hate discarding either one. Salvage. That's basically half a salvage anyway, right? It's draw one instead of draw two. Alright, so at 8 mana, I don't get to play Treasure Trove plus anything else right now. Lady Wildfire with the tier 1 sub. Thank you so much for a brand new tier 1 sub. Y'all get a bunch of hype boats in the chat for that support. Thank you so much there, Lady Wildfire. So yeah, I guess it's just Treasure Trove. Yeah, we'll go Treasure Trove. Let's see what we get. We get 5 cards to play. Could double spell with the Devour Adepts, but... we have 5 cards here. Alright, so we have Unlicensed Innovation. We have
glory, courage, excuses for war.
It's kind of bad. Nah, check that. That's really bad. Smooth Soloist?
On a musical journey.
Herald of Spring? No! Card's pretty tough.
That's it.
Right out.
Hmm. And no reason to hold on to this Ranger's resolve.
Why are you here?
I was gonna see if something died. I was gonna see if something died for remembrance. So that's why I waited on that. So that was my last one. I think I play this right now because I don't really want to draw a sea monster for turn, so it just takes another sea monster out of the deck of like a sea monster that I could draw for turn. Our deck is 20% treasure troves, so we had a 20% chance of drawing treasure trove. What else we got? Oh no! Need that a little bit ago. Arena bookie? Okay, this one was not nearly as good. I don't even think I want arena bookie.
Oh, would you look at these eyes?
So I guess I'll sacrifice arena bookie to the butcher. Do I want Arena Bookie discarding Abyssal Eye and drawing a new card? Do I want to discard Abyssal Eye and draw a new card? I'm four away from deep right now. Tough call. That's just a really tough call. I'm not sure if that is something that I do want. Alright, let's see what we get. No.
Victory at any cost.
Didn't get to do this other treasure trove. Okay. We're gonna draw a lot of cards. We had like Trifarian Assessor that was gonna draw us a lot of cards. Yeah, the Zaps Brayfins just killed me. You know, they just dealt too much damage to me and then you know, Leviathan and Noxian Fervor finish it out. Got too much damage. You kind of noticed that against, like, those decks with just those Twisted Fate Twain decks. We were just taking too much damage from the early things and just not being able to get good enough defense out there against stuff fast enough. So Jettison did look good for us. I would say Jettison looked good. Coral Creatures, honestly, I just don't think Coral Creatures is good enough. I mean, the 1-2 just really doesn't matter, and it wasn't very good. The Coral Creatures did get to do two cool things, though. It got to make that counterfeit copies that gave us a bunch of more treasures. That was pretty cool, even though it ended up not helping, but that was cool. But then the other game, we did make a Jettison with Coral Creatures. So, like, we had two great hits with Coral Creatures. Because, yeah, we got to make a Jettison. That was awesome. Petty Officer, though, in this deck, again, another card. Just don't really... We're never going to make the Powder Keg. All this does is just, like, fill up our board with just, like, crappy things that we don't really want. And, like, if they don't chump block, they're not helping whatsoever with Coral Creatures and Petty off the one drop and stuff like that. Like, that's all these things are doing. I think that we need more removal spells, like more gotchas. I kind of like Sprayfin. Like, Sprayfin was okay getting Lure and Jettison. But, like, instead of Petty Officer and Creatures, I think we just need more removal spells, like gotchas and Mystic Shots and stuff like that. Need more ways, like more fast speed cards, more ways to use spell mana, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that was definitely some fun games. Definitely got to do some fun games, but honestly, I just like this more. I just like having Rummage to help level up Twisted Fate faster, and also just, you know, rummage through the deck, have Jury Rig to discard to rummage for your blocker, and then Sump Dredger, another way to go through the deck real fast, and Gotcha as a removal spell. I just like just going through the deck real fast. But this doesn't have Jettison, and Jettison did look good. Maybe Jury Rig could be Jettison, but I like having something that you really want to discard with Rummage, Urchin, and Sump Dredger. Maybe find room for Jettison, because the Jettison definitely looked good. Expect, you know, getting us to be deep quickly. All right, but there we go. That's Twisted Deep. Those of y'all watching on YouTube, hit that like button over there. Hope y'all had some fun with all the treasures and stuff like I just did there. But anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.